to assert yourself defensively in that second quarter. He forced three straight turnovers at one point. What did you notice about the defensive effort?
Well, we kept them out the paint. The biggest thing was we was making shots, not allowing them to play fast and play in transition. That's what they're good at. That's how they start the game off. Turnovers, not bad shots, but just, you know, fast break shots that we were taking, which leading to easy baskets for them. Once we slowed that down, we forced them to play in the half court. That was more our game.
It seemed like you and Russ were really enjoying watching Terrence go out there and get his. What's that like watching a rookie?
I think we were just more excited about the rest, being on the bench. You know, it's just great. You know, we see the development day to day with Terrence. He puts the work in. I said it, you know, earlier. He's first, you know, as soon as I got here, I noticed he was a huge talent. I was very impressed with his work ethic, with his, you know, natural talent. The kid is really good. And, yeah, he reminds me of myself a lot, you know, early on in the league. Just a sponge trying to take everything in. But, man, he's special. He's a special weapon, special talent.
What was better, his threes or the dunks?
Threes. You know, as a young guy, starting 0-for-2 behind the three-point line, and still the confidence to keep shooting. You know, that's what really stands out, is that confidence to keep going.
You mentioned earlier you guys being able to put the ball in the basket really helped. Russ seemed to find you a lot on the move, pin downs, curls, elevator screens. How much does that help you to be able to catch kind of on the move in triple threat position?
Yeah, it helps. You know, get a defender not knowing or what to expect on my catches. Whether they shoot or drive, definitely puts me at the advantage. But you know, I just try to be available, try to move space for Russ. He's so good at attacking and getting into the paint. You know, my job is just to get open.
What did it mean to you to hear the reaction from the fan base when you were in there?
It was awesome. It was awesome for one, just being home, being in front of friends, family, and then, you know, just the respect, the love, the recruitment. You know, it was awesome. It was awesome to get that love, that energy.
Can you remember receiving anything like that on the road before?
Recently in Indy. it was the opposite. But you know, not on the road. I get a fair, decent amount of cheers every time I came home and played in LA. Tonight was definitely more.
Worked out nice to give your mom and dad a hug there after your three.
Yeah, after they was late. Came late. I told them to. But it was nice. You know, it's nice for them to be in Staples Center. It means, you know, just as much as me playing out there. It means that much more.
PG, LA again tomorrow. What's the key to be as equally efficient as you were tonight?
Just know, understand, it's a different team, different LA team. Quick turnaround for us. Understand, we got to come here and take care of business, get ready for another opponent. You know, we got to, you know, be able to, you know, take the good things that we did tonight, take it with us for tomorrow night. But just be mindful, it's going to be a different game.
Is this what you envisioned when you signed, when you were traded to OKC, as, you know, this kind of efficient team with your performance tonight?
Absolutely. When we're clicking and we're in a good rhythm, everybody knows their job, knows what to do and what to bring to this team. We're going to have, you know, nights like tonight.
Paul, you've talked a little bit in the last couple of days just kind of about the history here and the people here and your family here and all that stuff. Is that something you can feel when you're actually on the court? Does it affect you at all, emotionally at all, when you're first taking the court?
Nah. I mean, it's great to see familiar faces. You know, outside of my parents, there was, you know, maybe five or six other, you know, personal friends sitting courtside that I knew. You know, it's just great. It's great that, you know, for one, they'll come out and support, and you know, it just, this is home. It's comfortable for me. So, No, it's just great. You know, it's great to be home and play in front of friends.
Is it specifically like you hit a three and then you get to go over and hug your parents and say hi to them in the middle of the game? Is that just a particularly nice moment for you?
Yeah, it's just a nice moment. It's typically not something I do. When they're home, they don't get no love. So it's just being home.
What were your impressions of the Lakers? Expected coming in and how they
played? Well, I mean, you can't make expectations, or really I can't have any. One of the best players was out tonight. Lonzo is really the engine. The way they came out and played, I suspect that's the way they're used to with Lonzo playing the point, just playing fast, high pace, high energy. But I mean, it's what you expect in a young team. You know, they're gonna have their bruises. They're gonna have their wounds. The best thing is they have young guys that are, you know, potentially gonna be big names in this league. They just, you know, got to continue to keep working and fine tuning themselves. But they got good young talent.
Thanks, PG.
Thanks, PG.